Welcome to the 3DN Expert Summit. My name is Ivo van der Lagemaat. I'm a product owner for 3DN Docs. And in this session, I will talk about what metadata binding in 3DN Docs can teach us about decoupled metadata integration and the future of taxonomy features. The agenda for today is the metadata binding demonstration, how to create and build it, and also give a short demonstration about the future of taxonomy features. All fields are configured and stored in a 3DN Content Manager database. For the restrictions on the fields for Content Manager is only a flat list. We can contact other repositories for us for field values, and this is done by the metadata binding extension. Those field values are retrieved as a set of tags, and each tag should have a unique identifier. When we're going to display those field values in our UIs, we contact the other repository and ask for those labels. So you always have the up-to-date label. It's up to the other repository how to organize tags, and those tags can be organized as a flat list, or it can be a graph. The other repository can be a PIM system, but it can also be a taxonomy, as an example. Now I'm going to show you how to do a Jira integration. I will show you how to retrieve a list of issues, searching on those issues, and also do the validation on those identifiers. I will show you how to install and configure the extension. Let's write the Jira integration. So let's open Visual Studio and create a new project. We choose class library, give it a nice name like Jira Handler. Next, and then select basically .NET Standard 2.0. because we're still running the full framework, so 2.1 is not going to work. So please select .NET Standard 2.0 if you're going to create an extension for 3DN Docs. So it will create. I will also rename a bit of my class, as a Jira handler. And before to continue with the project, I still want to copy a couple of assemblies. So we actually have a ish CD, that is actually the CD layout of the installation of 3DN Docs. There is a resources sections there with code, and there's a zip file plugin samples. So I've extracted the zip file into this folder, and there's a bunch of samples of all the extensions and all the handlers that we have, also with unit tests as well. There's also a section for the integration libraries, and if you want to start writing the handler that we're going to do in this short demo, you need to have a reference to this assembly, that is the plugin SDK. I will copy it, and then I will create a folder. So it's also libraries. So it belongs a bit to our project. And then you're gonna add basically a product reference, and then we can browse to it, and then we can actually select it. Oh, it's invalid, so I will browse to it. There's the one that I copied, and I will have it as a reference. Before to continue, we also need a couple of NuGet packages in our project, not the ones that we already installed. We want to search on it, so we want also have Newtonsoft, because we have a Jira integration and the Jira response is in JSON. So to use a bit of strongly typed models, it's always nice to have a nice integration with Newtonsoft. So that one is installed. We want to have the system component model composition, and that is because the whole plugin mechanism in 3DN Docs is working using the MEF framework from Microsoft. So that's why we need to make it sure that it's properly loaded. And of course, in our demo, we also do a little bit of caching, so not on every request. We're gonna do full load of a whole list of items. So we're gonna install that one. And once that done, we're gonna back to the Jira handler. And this is actually from iHandler, and that is from the SDK of 3D Docs. There you see, there it is. And now, like I said, we also make sure that we export this class to the Math Integration Framework. So we want to give it a name, call it Jira Handler, and this name is important later for our configuration. And then we want to say, hey, what type are we going to implement? And that's basically the iHandler. Now we have the iHandler, and then of course we need to implement a couple of interfaces. So here we have the interfaces that we need to implement to have a successful Jira integration. So when the plugin is loaded, we call actually initialize, and the initialize will supply with some configuration. In the configuration, there are parameters that you actually specify in your configuration, and that is actually pushed to your handler. And then in this handler, you can actually try and catch to get those parameters and their values. And it's rather handy actually to test if the parameter is there. If not, then you just throw an exception, and then actually it will fail to load this plugin. So you cannot use it anymore. It's also and of course, for the hostname, we also need a username for actually for some credentials, so username and password. We also supply the board ID as well. You can only actually for parameters, you can put in strings. So if you are receiving a string and you want to actually use it as a number, for instance, you can also do a try parse in this initialize, see if that is successful. If not, you can still raise an exception to do so. In the configuration also, there's a log server, so you can also put it as a member of your class, so you can also use it later on in other methods as well. For the HTTP client, we will also do the authorization, and we're going to set some basic authentication to this, and then we need to use this basic authentication, and for this one we need the username and password sent, and actually put it as a base64. And then you have the log servers, and then if your log is successful, you can write something like that it's successfully configured for the Jira handler. Those are actually, here are the most important methods to implement. So it's actually for resolving IDs, you get a bunch of IDs to resolve, basically to the stacks. This is also the three stacks, it gives you some context how to actually maybe perform a search or search on it. And this is basically a retrieve text structure. This is basically the whole tree, how it's going to look like. And here's some validation. So it provides you a validation context with some identifiers. You have to validate if they are exist. And you can also raise some exceptions. We only supply basically some identifiers or some interfaces to it. And we still need to have some proper classes that implement those interfaces. So for that one, I'm gonna create a new folder. I always would like to call them like something like models. I also prepared already a little bit on this to make it a little bit faster, because it's a lot of typing, and then I don't have that much typing, that much time to do all the typing. So I can copy paste and then put them in my solution. This de deer handler, de deer handler, en this one is de models. Here I put basically all the models. So here you actually see that you implement the particular interface to a class, and then I use getters and setters for those properties. And that is basically it for all the interfaces that we that you actually show in this handler. This is actually how I'm gonna do it. So before actually returning the resolved ideas of the retrieve text or the text structure, we first need to communicate to Jira and build up our own tree. And this is also, I prepared this one as well. I just copy paste it. So here I actually want to build the Jira taxonomy tree, but I also want to return it basically as a tree as well. So that's also why I need some models for this one as well. So I also created some models to help me doing this. So let's go to the models and do all the Jira related models and copy them also into my project of the Jira handler, and there are the models. So basically this model structure of the Jira response, this basically start at max result and total, and this is actually reflecting this kind of response. So this is the request we're gonna fire, and this is basically the response we wanna receive, and actually building up a structure to reflect it. So here is basically the Jira response. You saw also the issues. That is actually a Jira issue, and the Jira issue is actually the the ID itself and the key that you saw over here. The issue. And in there is actually a dictionary of strings that is actually fields. And this is, for example, the summary, but there are more fields, so you can also extend it in the future if you like. We also want to actually build up our own Jira taxonomy. And so we also have like a list of tags and also have the tags relations. So the tags are actually only the basic the issues of Jira. And here you can actually specify how the relations between those issues is. So for this demo, they don't belong to each other, but you can also build a graph if you would like, but that is not the case in this demonstration. So basically, does it does it find it already now, the Jira taxonomy? Yeah, it will find it and it will actually build it. So what I actually gonna do is gonna cache it a little bit as well. So my board ID is actually basically the cache key. If I have some memory cache to do, I actually use it. So the memory cache is on the default one. I can see if this one exists with this board ID. If it exists, I return it. If it does not exist, I will actually get a non-cached Jira taxonomy. So actually gonna talk straight to Jira to retrieve the list. So this is basically, let's see if I have my cache lock defined as well for this one. Probably didn't put it there. Static. I think it was this one, how it was specified over there. Oh, cache lock. I there have my cache lock. So this one works. So I'm now going to actually do the non-cache direct taxonomy. I built first a list of all the tags and the tag relations. And actually the first tag I want to add is basically the Jira one. So I'm going to say Jira and also have a description with a particular board ID. So this is basically the first node in my tree. And it's also important to add the tag relations. And if you want a new tag relations, also the root one, you don't specify basically the from. Here you say from ID, the from ID you leave blank, and that actually indicates that this one is a tag that you use at the top level. So specify here, I want to have a 100 results as a max. I implement something for retrieving the issues, and if I have basically the issues, I loop in the response through all the issues and add basically a new tag to it, a new tag structure. I give it the identifier of the particular issue ID, that isn't really a number. And also as a label, I use the key. I will show you though, I use the ID. So the ID is important that we store basically in a content manager, in the database. And the key is basically also maybe easy to recognize for the user that's actually seeing this tag in the UIs. And also this is some kind of description. In a description you can also maybe only use the summary, and for the label maybe we can use the key plus the summary. You can also specify if a tag is selectable. That means you can actually select it in the UI and use it. And for this one, for the root one, I actually said that it's not selectable. You can still navigate through it, but you cannot select it and use it as a tag in a field. When that is done, I actually create my Jira taxonomy. I put the tags and all the tags relations there. So going back to the request to Jira, when retrieving the issues, I basically have the HTTP client do a call from the hostname plus the whole URL with the particular board ID you can actually specify. So this one, it makes it also possible to use this plugin for different kind of fields with linked to different kind of boards. So only the configuration is changed, but the plugin remains the same. I can also do a start at and a max result. So you can also maybe loop to stuff if you need like more items, not in one call, you can actually loop through it. So I gonna wait for the response. I can also test the response method if it is successful. You can also do something like ensure status goes okay, if not okay, if it's thrown exceptions. That's something you can do. You can also do check the result, and if it's not there, you can also log an error, but still continue. And here you actually do the deserialization of the Jira response into this object, and this object later is used for actually building the whole tree structure. So now gonna start basically with the retrieve text structure. So how we can actually do that one. So basically prepare this one as well a little bit. Let's copy paste some code in there and I will explain it. So this is my Jira taxonomy. I just retrieve the whole taxonomy. And then actually create a retrieve text structure result and actually put the text as the taxonomy text I just retrieved from Jira, and also do the relations there as well. So it's also can build up a nice graph when showing the content to you. And the message is just an empty list in this case. You can also do this for the resolve IDs. I can do the implementation. Let's copy. Oh, and then paste. So this is basically the same. This is also getting first my taxonomy. So this one is probably already cached now. And I will return basically the results. And I'm only interested basically those IDs, those tags, basically where we have an identifier. And this is also used when we actually want to display the list. So we have a list of identifiers, but still want to show you the field values. And this is the way we do it. So the handler is called with a bunch of those IDs, and you actually return those full tags. So it also contains the label, the correct label, the up-to-date label, and that one is actually then displayed in the UI. We also have a function also for retrieve tags. I also prepared this one. So it's also now relatively simple when you actually have the whole tree basically. You can also very easily implement those features. This one is of course the done on the cached version for a couple of minutes. So we cache it in this case for about 5 minutes. But this does not prevent you to also to go directly to Jira as well. But having the cached version of the Jira taxonomy is a little bit faster. But if you want to also have the always up-to-date version, you can also change this implementation and talk directly to Jira to retrieve those labels. So here we can actually do a retrieve text. And this is also, yeah, we have basically the taxonomy. And in the taxonomy, we're going to search for all the tags that basically start with a some text. So that is basically input filter. So for the, we also support in the UI that you can type some text, and then we gonna find some hits in the taxonomy that represent what you actually typed. So this is how we did it in this implementation. But also you can talk to straight to Jira and also fire the query there and return the response. So basically this is it for the whole implementation of the handler. And of course, once we have written handler, we can also always install it, but maybe also a better idea is actually to first. So basically what I have to do is go to my instance. So I have here my Tridion instance basically. Here's my Jira handler, I have a link to it. I just have written it one, you can also see the date and time. In the debug one, and then you can actually see this is the Jira handler, and I'm gonna install it in my docs instance. So normally you have it installed in InfoShare folder, and then in app you have a plugins folder, and then actually all the plugins, the custom plugins that are written, you actually put them into one folder. So here's my Jira handler, and we already have something like the 3DN doc sites taxonomy, but also some other plugins written as well and installed. So this is basically how you install the plugin, but installing it is not enough. We also need to configure it. So I prepared a little bit about the configuration. So you basically have an InfoShare extension config, and then you actually also define it on the metadata binding. And the metadata binding, you specify which fields of Tridion docs you're gonna use for your handler. So basically you're saying, so my field, this field, like pool party concepts, I have a source reference to Jira, and it could reference to a source. So this is my source, it is Jira, and the handler is Jira handler. And this Jira handler is the one that we actually mentioned over here. So that is important why those names should match. And then you have the initialize with all the parameters, and the parameters basically also what you saw in our unit test. You have the host name, you have the username, password, and also the board ID. So if I now copy paste it and then go to my content manager instance, I can actually easily replace it, and then I can save it. So now it is saved, and now if I go to my repository and go to the properties of a topic, here you basically have the field, the concepts. And if I now press on this one, it actually will load. It will talk to our Jira plugin that we just have written, and now you can actually see the whole list of Jira issues SA3. So we say, hey, this is the top one, we call it the Jira one, and underneath there basically the the other issues, but you can also build your own text structure as well. So the whole graph. So basically also you want to number it, all the 7,000 are belonging to a node, and on underneath all the 7,000 are there. It's just an example. Maybe you have different kind of keys. You can also order them by key. It's up to you. It's up to the handler how to do it. If you have it, we also support something like searching on it as well. If I type it incorrectly, it will limit the list. It does not really matter what you type. It also finds items in the middle of the label. It's up to the handler how to interpret it or how to write it. This is something we do. We also have support, like if you don't load the whole list, but you can opt with some kind of suggestions. And then you can also find all your items there as well. And then you can actually select it. And now it is selected, and you can select multiple. And after that, you can actually save it as well. Let's continue with the future of taxonomy features. So we've written a metadata binding for a JIRA integration, but you can also write one for a taxonomy integration. But if you write one, still people have to pick and choose the right concept from that taxonomy. Would it not be nice if it's actually possible that we save the topic content and then scan it and then extract the concept from it and then store it as a topic field? So you can also use the write plugin basically for doing this. Gonna have a small demonstration of how that is done. So we basically have our configuration topic for Microsoft SQL Server, and in here you actually have your concepts, and here you can actually browse through your whole taxonomy. And in the taxonomy on the technology there are databases, and then you have basically SQL Server. You can easily navigate through the taxonomy. Or indeed, like we've seen before, you can also type it and it will actually limit the list where you can basically choose from. So there is nothing selected at the moment. So if I have my topic, and in this topic I add some extra text and then actually save it. So basically saving it. And then doing the save, we actually get the content, we scan it, looking for concept in your text. And if we find one, we update the fields of the topic. So from this one, I just save it. I open my properties. And here you can see that it found basically Microsoft SQL Server. So in doing the save, we actually classify your content in the taxonomy. And also this will improve findability for your users. And if you want to know more about this, please join us at Connect 2021. So this is it basically. And if you want to find more information about the metadata binding, you can find it on docs.sql.com. Thank you for joining the session, and enjoy the rest of the 3DN Expert Summit.